Distilling engineering design principles. What is the essence of engineering design, and what are the principles upon which it is based? I searched for an answer to this question because it enables the connection from ecological design to hydraulic engineering, nature-friendly design. Also, if engineers can explain why they think and act in a particular way when designing, it can open up negotiation space with other disciplines, and vice versa. When other disciplines understand what motivates engineers, it can open up the multidisciplinary design space. In this video, I'm going to distill engineering design principles, the essence of engineering design. When designing, each engineer seeks to reconcile the function required of the infrastructure with the hydraulic boundary conditions and the load that it will experience. They do this to a required standard and at reasonable cost. So these represent two principles of engineering design. First, designing to meet a requisite standard. That is, the structure should withstand all conditions apart from those exceeding the design criteria. Examples are levees such as that at Ficksburg, or storm surge barriers like the Thames Barrier, built to withstand a certain water level. Second, reasonable cost. This is a pragmatic consideration that it behoves an engineer to take into account. After all, an unnecessarily expensive structure just won't get built, and a cost-cutting version may not continue to meet the safety standard in the long term. A professional engineer is responsible for the trade-off, minimizing cost while maintaining standards. But how's this done? Well, each engineer considers how the hydraulic structure can fail, the failure mechanisms, and seeks to prevent such failure. This leads to two further engineering design principles. The third principle, structural integrity. That is, the structure should be built of appropriate material and in an appropriate fashion so that it doesn't become unsteady or unbalanced, but retains its resistance to loading. That is, its structural integrity, its strength, stability, and the stiffness in the structure. Not like at Peacehaven in England. You can't place large rocks or concrete blocks of a breakwater directly onto a sandy substrate, for example. They'll become unstable and subside or slump as time passes. The fourth principle is reliability. That is, the structure should continue to function smoothly and well and shouldn't require many repairs. Unlike the lock in France, where plant matter in the water jammed the mechanism and it took some time for repairs to occur. In general, the simpler the structure, the more likely it is to be reliable. So this principle also incorporates the idea of maintenance, that a structure can be maintained so that it remains reliable. The other engineering design principles stem from the functions of the infrastructure, and they revolve around the requirement to control environmental variability to ensure access, connection or supply. So for instance, a lock is designed to connect two bodies of water in such a way that ships can move from one body of water to the other by the control of the water level within the lock. And a breakwater has a dual function, withstanding variability to a requisite safety standard and yet ensuring accessibility by controlling the variability of the wave conditions behind the breakwater. A major dam in a river is designed to control the variability in river flow by storing it to ensure supply. The more variable the river flow, the larger the dam needed to provide a particular assurance of supply. The functional requirements to control environmental variability and to meet a requisite standard by withstanding variability are two sides of the same coin. They're only separated here for clarity. Next, practical considerations related to building and operating the structure play a role. The underlying design principle here is implementability. This principle entails checking whether it is feasible and reasonable to construct and operate the infrastructure. Tried and tested methods are generally preferred above entirely new ones. An exception is the Eastern Schelt storm surge barrier, for which many new design and construction methods had to be developed. Another principle that is not commonly applied is that of adaptability. This means taking potential future changes in the function of an infrastructure into account in the design phase. So, when designing a quay wall, for instance, it should be designed so that it can be raised or reused at a later stage to accommodate the next generation of ships that have deeper drafts. And it is possible to distinguish one more design principle, resilience. Resilience is the capacity of the engineering structure to withstand a second shock or a high load of similar magnitude to the first disturbance and yet retain its structural integrity and continue to meet the functional requirements. An example is a flood protection barrier, successfully withstanding first one flood without significant structural damage and then being subjected to another big flood and successfully withstanding this. To summarize, so far I have distinguished 8 hydraulic engineering design principles. If we regroup these slightly, we have requisite standard, control of environmental variability, reasonable cost, structural integrity, such as strength and stability, reliability, implementability, adaptability, and resilience. But this is by no means an exhaustive list. But it does indicate the often implicit trade-offs that engineers are making in their designs. Each principle requires you to think about the abiotic environment and its variability. Maybe by withstanding, controlling, or regulating the variability, or considering the types of materials at the site or nearby. This brings us to the 9th and most fundamental engineering design principle, understanding the abiotic environment sufficiently to determine appropriate hydraulic boundary conditions and loads. So we have appropriate hydraulic boundary conditions and loads. Now that you've learned about engineering design principles, for the non-engineers amongst you, did you notice it's all about failure? And for the engineers, you may not have realized that other disciplines just don't know that engineers think like this, that you care that infrastructures don't fail. So to return to the original question, do you now know what the essence of engineering design is? Well, engineers apply design principles to prevent failure. It's all about preventing failure. Thank you for your attention.